line, all of those that are in the frontline services, to make sure nga adda iti mang sustain nga makan kasi ay. So we all know syempre that in the local government, it is composed of the barangay, the municipality, and the provincial. So in urge na po gobernador dagiti barangay and the municipality to work with him all together. May sa common goal tayo kunana, let us not allow nga adda agbisin during this calamity. So at the calamity fund iti barangay, kudos also to them because they tried their best no anati maiugment da, and then of course kudos to the municipal government at kinita damot na anadigiti maiugment da, and then of course the provincial government. The provincial government, syempre yunayon ko na tayo ata, ti iskup ti provincial government na kalawlawa dayta. So we have to plan who are those nga immediate nga naapektaran, isu ta dapat ti maikanan. Kasi ay, syempre dagiti the barangay may be able to give no anamo ti maitidan, and then the municipio may kina be it appoint nga no mabalin may kandamin. But on our part, because naka-adu, naka-lawlawa, i-identify, dagiti talaga nga makasapol. And then, came also the brainstorming no kasanong nga matulungan dagiti awanan ti trabahon na apektaran. So, came in the cast for work. Dagiti other nga, dagiti di Manila kumakon kunada, masapol nga dagiti pagtrabaho na. Da tayo, nabayagan nga dagiti cast for work tayo. So, minitig na kami na po gobernador and ni po DSWD at the 15 million na. Then ni
Tourism.
Tourism kasi imununa pa lang ni Enro. At the 15 million na. And then in-identify yun no, asino nagi umuna so that the plans will be already prepared. And then came in, they take challenge na. Di amin-amin nga departamento nga mangi-contribute kami from our budget ti mapan iti dayto to immediately address the need to the needs for us to be able to purchase anything that will answer this problem. So imuna nga nag-offer of course is the tourism office. We have already suspended all the events, so mabalin day jayon, which turns out to be a cast for work nga kasatay na explain tatay ni Ayan, ni Apo Provincial Tourism Officer, Mr. Ayan Ri Raquel, that it is to be given based on the project statement na identify na kita yung apektaran iti tourism industry. Siyempre, kita yung waiters, caterers, na kita yung agdadait, na kita yung event coordinators, like that. So they will be given something like an advance that no, they can sustain their mobility, but in return after that trabaho danto kasi to pinang-explain na tatay, so nang gyud di jay. And then then came in the cast for work under Miss Lilian, and also the honorable governor requested the regional office to assist us in this, and then the regional office through the PSWD and Enro was able to release 19 million for additional cash for work. So those are to answer DJ trabaho, bigay trabaho. At least masapul nga maamuan ti tao that the government from the barangay to municipality, especially the provincial government, is working for them, for all of them. Now si Maruno another, I should say, is syempre may dititi muna is the food packs. Adu dagitay kunada kay kayat miti bagas like Bado. They wanted bagas. Amuta yung mga ti Ilocos Norte, Ilocanos, I should say, are resilient na andorda. Nagagat, resourceful tayo. So provided nga da inapoy at da bagas tayo, adu ti mulmula tayo, adu ti marunggay, adu ti saluyot, adu ti utong, adu ti whatever. And then adala ka kamatis kin bugong tayo, masustainan tayo, pinagbiag tayo, di ba? So kuna pa idi brainstorming binijay, mas pa sa kanungan apektaran ti urban. Because in here, bakaon pagalaan dati barunggay, kas dyan, dagita yung tricycle drivers, iti nga dati, kas dati yung taga-baryo, natumangad kan, di ba, nakadadod yung arunggay kasi dyan. So, those are the things we did, and then in coordination with the municipal and barangay, through the barangay captain, syempre, isudang mo, nagkita makaamo, no, as in, talaga, nagkita, greatly affected di dyan, nag-submit dan, and then, nai-release immediately also. So, if the people would try to evaluate, they maanawan imo itinabaybayan, although agiin na no sa talaga nga dito imay nga ba ditay napakpakaadahan. We were only preparing for calamities like typhoon kasjay, flash floods, bagbagyo kasjay, but it's good for this typhoon amo tayo ti kalaban tayo danom angin, but this virus ba ditay makita no anas. That's why adot ti tao nga madi makaawat kada jay enhanced community quarantine lagi tay EO dapo gobernador, but only to tell them nga it is done tapno to ensure and safeguard public health and public safety. So tatan amon ti tao amudan nga talagan maawatanen tatan isu dapay mangpapiliten nga adda ada masapol nga quarantine tayon nagitay kalukaro ba mingarod no bagada nga da nagapuyo hospital ang sumsumrot ni barangay tayon dapat nag quarantine kung kunadan. So something like that, at least educated kita taon. So after that what else do we need to know sa parang, and then idi nag lockdown tayon nang meeting man ni Apo Gobernador. Kunana, you go now with the first round of the food provision. So nalpas the first round from the province. I know also the municipalities will be doing also their second round, and even the barangays. And aside from our resources, ipay may sa gayam in brainstorming and kinamiting na kami na po governor, pagalaan tayo iti fund because the calamity fund will not be enough. Now we were telling the honorable governor we can now use our calamity fund, the entire of it, the quick response and the preparedness, because there was already a declaration of a state of health emergency, although dagiti adoy bagadahan pay. But we are praying we were already urging the Sangguniang Panlalawigan should declare a state of calamity. Kadayta nga malum, and then itirabiin, declare ni Apo Presidente. So that solves the problem. Yeah. We can use now the calamity fund, and then thank you also to the national government agsasaruno ti guideline. Like what we are doing, we know that not also sleeping, thinking of possible solutions for this problem, to ease this problem or whatever. Nagsasaruno ti guidelines nga we can now use the both the all the calamity fund as if we define it properly, and then we cannot now use the previous balances of the calamity fund. So if you so at the inubramin nag source out kami the balances. If you remember the munang realignment or reprogramming was 52 million. That is already in addition to the, I cannot quote the exact figure of the 107 million existing calamity fund tayo. And then we also reprogrammed some of the items DJ 2020 da nga mabalin nga i-forgo pay laeng tapno umad adto ti calamity fund tayo. So that was 52 million in addition to that. And then the provincial departments, the various departments nag-contribute dan. So to go back to ayan, that's 12 million already. Yes. That's in response to the COVID, to the pandemic, to the effect of the COVID. And then provincial engineering contributed 27 million from some of their infrastructure. Mabaling nga ibaga tayo apay in contribute na importante na gito. But we can source out health as well. Is umuna. After this, hoping and praying for that we go back to normal situation, we can always find way to fund those projects na doon tumakailaan. And then, from the sports, we have 5 million. So that's 12 plus 27 plus 52. So as of now, we have those to use. And then right after the J declaration, the community enhanced quarantine, or even the first executive order, we already ordered PPEs. Nagiti protective mask, at least we are not prepared nga dapat dagiti kumagatangan tayo di mo pay amon na ti pressure da di ba the mask, the alcohol, everybody in the borders and the frontliners na ikan olduhan nga perfectly kasi tiko natin nga ro din hantay mo nga inasahan dito pero we thank all.